So in the previous part of the lecture, I was discussing about the synchronous generators, and they were basically operating at a constant speed, which was known as the synchronous speed. Now I will discuss about the induction generators and their introduction and concepts and their construction and operating principles. So basically, an induction generator or an asynchronous generator is a type of alternating current electric generator that is basically using the principle of induction motors to produce electric power. The induction generators operate by mechanically turning their rotors faster than the synchronous speed. A regular AC induction motor usually can be used as a generator without any internal modifications. Induction generators are useful in applications such as mini hydropower plants, wind turbines, or in reducing high pressure gas streams to low pressure gas streams, because they can recover energy with relatively simple controls. An induction generator usually draws its excitation power from an electrical grid. So because of this, induction generator cannot usually black start a de-energized distribution system. Sometimes, however, they are self-excited by using phase correcting capacitors that are basically added in parallel with the motors and generators. An induction generator produces electrical power when its rotor is basically turned faster than the synchronous speed. For a typical four-pole motor, two pairs of poles on a stator that are operating on a 60 hertz electric grid, the synchronous speed is like 3 times, so 60 multiplied by 3 is 1800 revolutions or rotations per minute. That is the standard RPM. The same four-pole motor operating on a 50 hertz grid will have a synchronous speed of 50 multiplied by 3, that is 1500 rotations per minute. The motor normally turns slightly slower than the synchronous speed. So the difference between the synchronous and the operating speed is known by the term slip, and it is usually expressed as the percentage of the synchronous speed. For example, a motor operating at 1450 revolutions per minute that has a synchronous speed of 1500 RPM. So the running slip speed is almost 3.3%. In normal motor operations, the stator flux rotation is faster than the rotation flux. This is the stator flux to this causes the basic stator flux to induce rotor currents, which create a rotor flux with magnetic polarity opposite to the stator. In generator operation, a prime mover turbine or engine it drives the rotor above the synchronous speed, so the slip is negative. The stator flux still induces current in the rotor, but since the opposing rotor flux is now cutting the stator coils, and active current is produced in stator coils, and the motor is capable of operating as a generator, and it is then sending the power back to the electric grid. So rugged brushless construction has basically removed the brushes, and the design is now brushless, and it does not need separate DC field excitation. So this has made the construction companies to basically maintain a low capital cost and low maintenance, and better transient performance behavior. It is extensively used in large wind plants and small hydroelectric power plants. Induction generators are often used as wind turbines in some micro hydro stations due to their ability to produce useful power at variable rotor speed. Induction generators are mechanically and electrically simple than the other generator types because they are more rugged, requiring no brushes or commutators. So basically they are available in different sizes and capacities which are greater than several megawatt. So three phase coils are placed on a pole of stator and excited via three phase power, in which the three currents are 120 degree out of time phase with each other for the construction purposes. So they produce a rotating magnetic field whose angular speed termed as the synchronous speed, and ns is given by the formula 60 times f by p, where f is the supply frequency and p is the number of pole pairs. The rotor consists of the conductor bars in slots on electromagnetic core. All the conductor bars are shorted to at both ends by the end rings, and this assembly resembles a hamster cage or a squirrel cage. Such a machine is known as the induction machine or the squirrel cage induction machine. In wound rotor construction, the conductors from three phase windings take out via slip rings. The slip rings are required to maintain to be maintained at regular time instances because they go through frictional forces and thus introducing unreliability in the operation. So they require constant maintenance. Now I will discuss about the operation of a squirrel cage induction machine as a induction motor machine as a motor. Rotating magnetic field conceptual visualization is in the figure below. That this is the squirrel cage rotor, and these are the permanent magnets. This is the north pole and this is the south pole. So the relative motion between the rotating magnetic field and the rotor conductor bars induces voltage in them, and the relation is given by the formula derivative of I with respect to time. So this sets up circulating rotor currents because of being shorted by the end rings. Electromagnetic interaction between these currents and the stator fields produce a torque that is given by the formula T equals to K times phi multiplied by I2 times cos of phi2, where K is the construction proportionality and depends upon the construction parameters and the materials that are being in use. Phi is the magnetic stator flux magnitude, I2 is the rotator current magnitude, and phi2 is basically the angle between the rotor currents and the rotor voltages. Now I will discuss about the operation of a squirrel cage induction motor at synchronous speed. So there is an assumption that a machine is frictionless. It means that we will be ignoring the effect of friction that is being faced by the moving parts, and the rotor is massless, so with no loading. So we will also be negating the loading effect. The rotor would accelerate under the influence of induced torque and reach the synchronous speed. Zero current is induced in the rotor at this point, so zero torque and no more acceleration will be produced. The rotor, being massless, does not have an inertia, so there will be no percentage overshoot, and the system response will be relatively close to critically damped system. So the speed remains at the NS, and the lack of friction enable the rotor to keep rotating at synchronous speed without facing any deceleration. So now I will be discussing about the operation of SCIM, squirrel cage induction machine, as a motor. The rotor will slow down if the mechanical load is attached to the rotor that is running at a synchronous or constant speed. So the conductor bar fall behind the stator field, and the torque induced in the motor with the magnitude corresponding to the degree of separation between the rotor and the rotating field. When the torque equals the applied load, the rotor attains new steady speed that is below the synchronous speed NS. Now I will discuss about the operation of a wound rotor induction machine as a generator. So basically, the induced currents and the torque reverse the direction of rotor that is attached to the wing turbine. Basically, they are providing an opposing force that is being generated by the wind to rotate the rotor. This is done by a step-up gearbox. So, and it is delivered to load via stator terminal. If the rotor speed or the synchronous if the rotor speed is basically less than the synchronous speed, the generator will be applying the active power to the grid via stator terminal connection, while the rotor of the machine will absorb the reactive power from the grid via back-to-back converters. This is known as sub-synchronous operation. If the rotor speed is greater than the synchronous speed, then the generator supplies active power to the grid via a stator terminal connection, while the rotor supplies the reactive power to the grid via back-to-back converter. This form of operation is known as super or hyper-synchronous operation. If the rotor speed and the synchronous speed are generator, then the generator supplies active power to the grid via stator terminal connection, while the rotor of the machine absorbs supplies no reactive power from or to the grid via back-to-back converter. And this type of operation is called the synchronous operation. So these are the basic modes of operation of wound rotor induction motor as generator, when the which can be summarized that if the rotor speed is equal to the synchronous speed, we call it the synchronous operation. If the rotor speed is greater than the synchronous speed, we name it as hypersynchronous operation. And if the rotor speed is less than the synchronous speed, then this type of operation is known as subsynchronous operation.